Hi all, today we are going to see about two-phase commit protocol which is under distributed transaction. So we have studied what is distributed database. So in your distributed database, if you are going to have any transactions between your distributed database, then you need to see, have certain responsibility of how it is being accessed and how it has to be done. So a transaction can be under different sizes. In your normal database, you can have a different transactions. Each and every transaction has to be executed such that it has not been conflicted or interleaved with each other. So here, as you're going to have distributed database itself, you must be careful about accessing or executing your transactions. So here I'm going to have some responsible for each, and I'm going to give responsibility for each and every site. As I have given you definition about what is site already. Site means each and every site will have a database. For example, if I'm going to have this site, I can have 1, 2, 3. So I can have, these are all the different sites of my database. So each and every site will have a database. So each and every site will have DB. Consider that here you have S1, here you have S2, here you have S3. So each and every site has been connected to a database. Please adjust with my drawing tool because it is very difficult to draw in the screen. So all these sites will be connected with a distributed. This is what your distributed database. So here you will have a whole database. This whole database is distributed under different sites. So each and every site will have a local transaction manager. So each and every site will have a local transaction manager. That particular manager is responsible for communicating to the overall transaction coordinator. In centralized database, you will have a transaction coordinator who is responsible for coordinating the all the sites. So each and every site will maintain a log. I told you what is log already. Log is like a notepad which is used to maintain what are all the process or transactions or what are the process that has been taken under site one. So each and every site will have a log. So S1, S2, S3 will have a log which is responsible for maintaining what it has been happened already. So for next, transaction coordinator is responsible for initiating the transactions between all the sites. So each and every distributed transaction will have a sub-transactions. So the coordinating the each sub-transaction is being done by transaction coordinator. So the transaction coordinator is responsible for committing all the sites or aborting all the sites. I hope you all have understood. I'll copy this somewhere, okay? I think I could not copy this. We'll have it in next slide also. Yes. So as I told you already, you have two levels of distributed database. One is a centralized database, which is being distributed along to three different locations. This is what distributed databases. So if you're going to have failure in your distributed database, it is being reason, the reason for distributed database failure is because of either failure of site, or it might lose or lost the messages because of network failure. You might lose the messages which is being transferred between sites. And next is about communication link failure. So each and every site will be connected with each other, so that if the site 2 transaction or site 2 needs the data from site 3, means it can be communicated, it can be transferred through this link which is called network link. Next, each and every network is partitioned so that it has been splitted into two or more subsystems, so that you can anyhow you will have a connection between each of the subsystems. So there you, if you are going to have any failure between the network partitioning and site failure, it is not distinguishable, because we cannot find whether network has failed or whether the site itself has failed. we cannot distinguish between the network failure and site failure. That is what has been given over here. Next is about your commit protocol. As I told you already, this commit protocol with the help, when as you're going to have a distributed transactions, you need certain protocol to make sure that it is been executing properly without any failure and without any interrupt. So this commit protocol is used for executing a distributed transactions properly. So this commit protocol ensures that you must have your atomicity across all your sites. You all have studied what is atomicity already. What is atomicity means? The definition for atomicity is all the operations must be either executed or neither should be executed. If you have six steps in your, if six operations in your one first transaction, all six transactions must be executed or neither of the operations should be executed in your transaction. The same process we are going to see it over here. If you have site one, the site one, if it has six operations, all the six operations must be executed under site one, or neither of the operations should be executed under site one. This is what the atomicity is. This atomicity should be ensured in your commit protocols. So out of ACID properties, only the atomicity property is being ensured in your commit protocol. So you have two types of commit protocol. One is about two-phase commit, the other one is three-phase commit protocol. We are not going to concentrate more on your three-phase commit protocol because it is complicated and expensive. But it adheres the drawbacks of your two-phase commit protocol. But even then, we are not concentrating more on your three-phase commit protocol. Mainly in your university questions or in your test, you will get only two-phase commit protocol. So now we are going to concentrate on your two-phase commit protocol. So as I told you already, two-phase commit protocol ensures your atomicity while execution of your transactions. What is two-phase commit protocol means? When all the sites of your transaction is executed, you must inform to the coordinator. What is, who is coordinator means transaction coordinator, who is responsible for all the sites. You must inform the execution and also you must inform the completion of your execution to your coordinator. Only the coordinator will ensure that whether you have completed your operations for your particular site. So you have certain steps for following all these things. You have two steps. One is about obtaining a decision. So under obtaining a decision, initially what will happen is the coordinator, I mean this coordinator, right? Wait, I'll have one highlighter. So this is what transaction coordinator, right? This transaction coordinator, what it will do is it will send the prepare message to all the sites. So if I have three sites, it can have any number of sites in my distributed database. Assuming that I have only these three sites in my distributed database, what this transaction coordinator initially will do is it will send the prepare message to all the sites to make sure that be prepared and you are going to have your operations to execute. So be prepared for executing all the operations. So that will be the communication between the transaction coordinator and the site. And after sending the prepare message, what this coordinator will do is it will have the log record where it will have the prepare message. So this is what the prepare message, which is being recorded in your log. It means that the transaction coordinator has sent the prepare message to all the sites. Once it sends the prepare message, the site one has to respond it back. Site one, site two, site three, all the sites has to respond it back to the transaction coordinator. Upon receiving the prepare message from the transaction coordinator, site has to respond it, right? So what the site will do is it will check whether I can execute my operation or not. If I cannot execute, what the particular sites will do is it will send an abort message. What is the abort message means? I cannot execute my transaction currently, so kindly don't ask me to execute anything. That is what the message of my abort. So this site one, what it will do is if it is not ready for its execution, it will send the abort message back to the transaction coordinator. And also you will have a log record, right, in all the different sites. So the log record will have the abort message. In short, I'm writing it as A. So it means that the A means I have sent an abort message to the transaction coordinator. That is what the log record. You all know what is the use of log record. Log record is used when you have a failure on your sites. Even if you have failures, you can get your data from your log record. If the transaction is ready to execute, it will send a ready message. If site one is it does not execute, it is not ready for its execution, it will send an abort message. If site two is ready for its execution, it will send a ready message. If it is ready means the transaction coordinator will think that okay, fine, site two is ready, so we can give the instructions to site two so that it can execute. So this ready message will be sent to the transaction coordinator and also it will be recorded in your log record. So and all the records will be into the stable storage. Next is, after getting the decision from the sites, the transaction coordinator has to decide which has to be executed, which has to be aborted. So that is what the name of the phase one, which is obtaining a decision. Obtaining the decision from different site is called obtaining a decision. So it is being given by the transaction coordinator. I'm sorry guys, resumes. Yeah. Next is phase two is I need to record the decision which has been given to by the sites. So after getting the ready message from the sites, I need to send some response to all the sites because they have given the ready message. It means that the particular site has been ready for its execution. If it has given the abort message, what it has to do is it has to record that this particular site has been aborted. So I cannot send any more message to that particular site. If it receives a commit ready message, then what it has to do is it can proceed the instructions to be executed by site two. Then after completing, the coordinator will add the decision like it has been committed. So once the site two has completed its execution, it will send the message like it has been committed and you can commit and it has been successfully completed. Now transaction coordinator had to add a message like commit of T. T means which particular site has been committed. So now I need to send a message of to the different sites about either commit or abort. So those who have given the ready message, I need to give commit T. Those who have given the abort message, I have to give abort T. It means that the transaction coordinator will give abort message to S1 because it has given abort, and for site two, it has to give commit T because it have given ready message. So transaction coordinator has to decide which particular site has to either commit or abort. If the particular site has given abort, then it has to give abort message. If the particular site has given ready message, it has to give commit message. So this has to be done properly so that only then the transactions can execute. Next, it is about handling of failures. So you can have failures in three different modes. One is about the site failure. If the particular site has got failed, what should be done? If the transaction coordinator has failed, what should be done? If the network failure has happened, what should be done? These three failures should be handled in your distributed database. So when the site has been failed, you need to check your, as I told you, as if any failures has happened, you need to check your log record. Log record is used for checking what all the actions that has been happened before the failure. If the log contains commit T, it means that the particular transaction is ready for its execution. So the site has to do only the redo operations. It means that it has completed the operations only, it has not been saved into your database. That is why we have to do redo operations. If the log contains abort message, it means that the particular site has been aborted, it has not yet started the execution, so it has to be undo. So undo will do the execution from first, redo will do the execution only from the where the failure has happened. And if you are going to have ready message, it means that the site must consult with the coordinator whether it has to redo or undo. The transaction coordinator has to be decided based on the messages. So next is about if the log does not contain anything, means what it has to do means after receiving the prepare, sorry, before receiving the prepare message itself, it has been failed. That is what the meaning of no message in your log record. Because only if I receive the prepare message, I will send the response, right? So if I have not received the prepare message, means what does it mean? The site has been failed before the prepare message itself. That is why you need to start from first. That is why you are going to perform undo operations. As I told you already in the class, undo means you are going to start the process from the initial stage. Redo means from the step where you have failed, from that you can continue it back. That is what the difference between undo and redo. Next, if your coordinator has failed, what should be done? Even the coordinator will have the log record. From the log record, you can attain what should be done. If the log record contains commit T, it means that the particular transaction has been given commit message, so it has to be committed. If the transaction, if the particular coordinator, I mean, the active site contains abort T, it is not necessary to mention to go and check with the coordinator, as because the coordinator itself has failed, so it can proceed further from the log record which has been already stored before the failure. Next, if this some sites does not contain ready message, means it means that it has not received the ready message. It means that the failed coordinator has to come back and it has to give the message to all the sites. So it if the site, particular site doesn't contain any ready message, means then you have to wait till the recovery of the transaction coordinator. So you have to wait till the transaction coordinator gets recovered. Next, if all the three cases has not been under or under the process, means what we have to do, means we have to either have ready message, or if we don't have any conditional records, means you have to wait. So if you have commit and abort message, you can do your commit and abort executions. If you are not going to have anything, you have to wait till the transaction coordinator has recovered. So because might be the transaction coordinator will take time to recover it. So till that time, the active state must wait till it has been recovered. So it might go under blocking problem. That is what the blocking problem is. It can wait for a long period of time to recover your transaction coordinator. Next is handling of failures. The handling of failures under network partition. So if you have any network failure, what you have to do? It means that if you have a coordinator and participants which is under same partition, if it is under same partition, means you will not have any network connection. So it means that you will not have any failures, because only a network failure should happen in these cases. So if you have the same partition, you will not have any failure. So you can proceed with your normal execution. If the coordinator and participants are in different locations, that means that if your transaction coordinator and the sites of different database are in different locations, means what you have to do is, and the coordinator think that what coordinator will think that the site has failed, what the site will think that coordinator has to have failed. But whatever it is, who have failed is doesn't matter. You have to wait till the recovery of the other person. So if I here I have two different levels of database. One is transaction coordinator, the other one is local site. If the network partition is being failed between the transaction coordinator and site, transaction coordinator might think that site has failed. What site will think? Site will think that transaction coordinator has failed, because we will not have any communication between each other. That is why these two people will not have any knowledge about actual reason of failure, because actually a network have failed. But what they both will think that each other have failed. That is why we have to wait till it has been recovered from your failure. If it is under, again, if it is under same partition, but it has been connected through network, means we have no other way. We have to wait till it has been recovered from your failure. This is what we have, three types of failures. One is about site failure, the other one is about transaction coordinator failure, the other one is about network partition failure. Thank you.